Before beginning, we would request you kindly subscribe to this channel. It will be a great way of supporting us. We have seen in the previous second episode the meaning of the sutram Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodha, that yoga is restraining the mind that remains preoccupied or distracted through the senses. Now, let us see how we arrive at this meaning by etymologically interpreting the sutram Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodha. It involves finding the origin or derivative history and development of its constituent words. Primarily, there are two components, the first one being yoga and the second Chitta Vritti Nirodha. Let us see the first word, yoga, and how is it derived. There is always a confusion in the derivative history of the word yoga. The first one is from the root yujir yoge, which means to combine or to unify and the like. And the second one is derived from the root yuja samadhau, which means to retract or withdraw or bring back and put in one place. The first derivative history is seen in circulation, though it neither holds textual support nor contextual suitability. The union between jiva and the brahma, that from which everything evolves, exists in and converges, has no support from the yoga treatise. Attainment of samadhi by retracting the mind that remains distracted through the senses and retention of it to attain a steadfast state called kaivalyam is the aim propounded by yoga. Therefore, the word yoga is derived out of the root yuja samadhau. So, yoga in a sense is nothing but samadhi that leads to a steadfast state called kaivalyam. By the way, the word samadhi will be explained in detail in the episode dealing with the sutram Tasyapi Nirodhe Sarva Nirodhad Nirbija Samadhi. Now, we have seen what is yoga, and the way to achieve this state is by doing Chitta Vritti Nirodha. Again, let us examine this word to find its meaning. There are three components in this compound, namely Chittam, Vritti and Nirodha. Chittam, in the current context, means the mind, the faculty that, when prompted by the intellect, helps perceive the material world through the senses, which are in contact with the sense objects, such as the mind in association with the eyes helps see the form of the objects. The mind in association with the ears helps hear the sound. The mind in association with the nose helps get the smell. And the mind in association with the tongue helps feel the taste. And the mind in association with the skin feels the texture through touch. Incidentally, it may be noted that perception is not simultaneous. For example, when we eat a piece of crunchy snacks, we hear the sound of it getting crushed by our teeth and also feel the taste. What do we get first? Is it the sound or the taste, or both simultaneously? In fact, if we closely observe, it is due to the proximity or nearness in space, time or relationship that we feel it as simultaneous. Factually, we get only one experience at any given time. If we focus on the sound, then we hear the sound. If we focus on the taste, then we get the taste. And now, vritti is really the shortened form of pravritti. In scientific parlance, the field where a sense organ is engaged is called its vritti. So, if someone says vritti kala, it refers to the period of engagement. And if somebody says vritti desha, then it means the place or field of such engagement. If further simplified, the activities or engagements or preoccupations of the chitta or the mind is chitta vritti. The word nirodha is derived out of the root rudhir avarane. As we started by saying that we need to understand these words by etymological analysis to find how meaning unfolds. Similarly, let us analyze this word. Avarana means veiling or concealing or covering or blocking and the like. And the prefix nir shows the complete veiling or concealing or covering or blocking. So, chitta vritti nirodha is nothing but completely retracting the mind from being engaged through the senses. What does it imply? It's better explained through an example. Suppose we sit in front of the television watching a movie and then toggle the channel with the desire to see the latest news. Next, we may wish to see the trending videos and switch the channel again. Now, the movie is still being telecast, though we are not tuned into it, and the news is still telecast, though we are not tuned into it. Similarly, all the world with its myriads of forms are still present, and all our sense organs are in perfect order, yet we have withdrawn them, and this is called nirodha. It's nothing but the bringing back of the mind from straying externally on sense objects to its internal source called the intellect. Senses in themselves are mere tools, like a camera. Anything passes in front of it is visible through its lens, but it doesn't capture the image. The operator has to do it. Similarly, mind's association makes the sense organs functional, which, when withdrawn, remains just as dead as a transistor radio or a television, not switched on and tuned in. This state at which the senses remain withdrawn and no more perceptions are allowed to take in is yoga. Chitta, or the mind, is generally preoccupied through the senses. That results in different kinds of engagements in search of happiness and pleasure, which sometimes leads to unhappiness and displeasure, and at other times even detrimental to others. These situations are not subject of yoga. These are the conditions that need to be checked. But at times, the mind becomes concentrated, focused, steadfast, and sometimes completely under control, withdrawn, restrained. And this steadfast state is the subject of yoga. Now there is a question. So in this state at which the mind remains withdrawn from the senses and no more perceptions are allowed to take in, or better say, in the state of yoga, what is our nature and what do we really see? The answer to this question will be provided in the upcoming video. Please stay tuned by subscribing to this channel.